Hey guys, you're Mark Kerberis, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool Chroma, where last time I have talked, I sealed the league title with wins over Swansea and Newcastle. So I have two massive cup games. The first is the FA Cup against Derby, for a place in the semi-finals, and then it's the second leg against Real Madrid in the Champions League. But first, let's Derby County. I've gone with something a little different for this game. I think for the very first time ever, I could be wrong, I have Ruben Neves, Emery Chan, and Donza in the center of midfield. Not one of them playing over the other two. They're all playing together. So, see how this goes. It's a bit defensive with probably Donza being the most attacking. I do have Neves, I think, in the camera. Or is he in the scene? We'll see in a second. When they bring the team. There's the semi quarterfinals. Spurs are playing Newcastle. United and City are also still there. So, tough semi-final awaits if I get past Derby. Jordan Ibe's still not back. If you saw the last episode, you know he's struggling with a bit of an injury. There you see I have Neves and Donza in the attacking roles, with Chan being the one who's going to be on defensive. And if I decide that it's not working, I could always switch it up. Rotation in is cool too. Well, I could easily move to a 4-3-3. He like a Derby are playing there, or as you saw. Well, that's another option. We're putting Kamano on a wide basis. I guess I'll see where I decide. Alright, but let's see how this lineup works. Still not that. No Bristow this time. It's Merales who is playing instead. And of course, like I said, Ibe is still recovering from his little injury. And boom, Danny Ings. He's the top goal scorer in the FA Cup, and he's off the mark in this match. That's a beautiful header from the Englishman. Whipped in very nicely by Merales. And it's a simple header from Danny Ings that any striker worth his salt, except Christian Benteke, will score every day. Yeah, because Christian Benteke is too fucking stupid and lazy. He to do what he's paid a lot of fucking money to do. And it's a fucking disgrace how anyone can argue after the piss poor performance. And I know it wasn't just Benteke who was piss poor, the rest of the team are piss poor as well. That loss was pathetic. I called the Andy Carroll goal moments before it happened. I was saying I could see it coming. I was like, I said to my dad, hey, this is a goal. I could tell from the second they got it out on the wide. I knew exactly what was going to happen. I knew it was going to get whipped in. It was going to be headed in. And the first goal was fucking bullshit anyway. It should have only been 1-0. And any West Ham fan who disputes that you're a fucking idiot. Because that was a clear foul on Mourinho by the West Ham defensive player. I don't know who fouled him, but Moreno, while he was attacking it at the other end, he was fouled. The referee didn't give it for whatever fucking reason, because he was paid off, or he was fucking corrupt, or just left his glasses at home, whichever it was. As he didn't give the fucking foul, and then and West Ham attack a weakened defense. Not that the defense is good at any point when they're full strength, but at least if Moreno was in his position, which he would have been had he not been fouled, then he would have, obviously, he at least tried to prevent the cross from going in, and they should never have gotten the cross in, because it should have been a free in for Liverpool than the other. And then, like I said, if you're a West Ham fan, you don't agree with that, and fuck you, you are obviously too blind by your win. You would have won anyway, because the Andy, nothing wrong with the Andy Carroll goal, except Liverpool's terrible fucking defending. Lovren saying we need to be stronger. You couldn't speak up about this beforehand, Dejan? You fucking moron. What the fuck is wrong with the defense? And people don't understand. I made my Liverpool transfer video the other day. And the first comment was that Mignolet shouldn't be replaced. Are you for real? If Mignolet didn't deserve to be replaced, we would be top of the table. Are we? No. Did we lose to West Ham? Yes. Did we lose to Watford? Yes. Did we lose to Newcastle? Yes. Would we have lost those games if we had a good defense? No, is the answer to that question. No. Oh, we wouldn't. Our defense has let us down too many times, and Mignolet is the key point of that defense, because he's the goalkeeper who doesn't fucking goalkeep. Seriously. I could put on a pair of gloves, fly over to Liverpool tomorrow, or in the next couple of days for our next game against Exeter. I could go in goal, and I guarantee you I'd do a better job than Mignolet. You could pick a tramp off the fucking street, and they'd do a fucking better job than Mignolet. The defense are useless. The defense are the attacker. Benteke, he's a fucking lazy cunt who doesn't deserve to wear that shirt. I would love to just rip the shirt off of him, because he doesn't deserve it. He didn't deserve his transfer to us. That's how we got robbed by Aston Villa. I will never know. I'm almost glad that they'll be fucking relegated, so I can laugh at them. And have a bit of joy at their expense, because they're no doubt enjoying that they got money for a player we should never have bought from them. Not that it was complete Aston Villa's fault, but it was totally 100% in Brendan Rodgers' fault. He should have kept his head on straight and signed good players with the money he got from every player we sold, both like Suarez and like Sterling. But no, he spent it terribly, and that's why he got sacked. Right. Now, Jurgen Klopp, I am imploring you, Jurgen, please, if you ever hear this, please, please sign defensive players. Yes, we need another striker, but first and foremost, sign a new center back and sign a new goalkeeper. I don't care if you don't want to give Mignolet a chance. You can have him. Give him his chance as the backup goalkeeper, who we never fucking use. We need a world-class goalkeeper, or we will never reach top four again. Because the fact that we got top four with Mignolet, we should get a fucking reward for that. Because that shit would be impossible. I guarantee you, no way we will get top four with Mignolet as our goalkeeper and with that stupid defense. Sacco is a terrible defender. I don't know why everyone says, oh, Sacco was brilliant. Sacco was brilliant. No, he is not brilliant. He has always made mistakes. He has always
is seemingly, he seems to be afraid of the ball. Oh, so let me get this straight. He's a professional footballer who's afraid of the ball. How does that work? How does that fucking work? That doesn't work. You have to be a strong, sturdy player to play in defense. It's, like I said from anyway, you could get a random person off the street and they do a better job than Mamadou Sakho. Oh, Dejan Lovren, when he has a good game, he is our best defender. Which makes a nice change from last season when he was fucking terrible. Oh. Skrtel is not having his best season as a Liverpool defender. I really like Skrtel as a player. He is normally our best defender, but this season he's been terrible. Oh. Klein so far this season is the only defender I wouldn't replace. Moreno is a terrible player. He can be good sometimes, but most of the time he's terrible. Oh. But there's not really a lot of choices at left back, so here's the solution. Get a new goalkeeper. Get a good goalkeeper. There are plenty of goalkeepers. Just spend the money. Give Jurgen Klopp what he needs to get who he needs. Jurgen Klopp won't make the same dumbass decisions as Brendan Rodgers. Whatever signs he makes will be good ones. But he needs a goalkeeper. If he doesn't want to sign one, force one on him. That is the only time I would accept the board stepping in, because we do need another goalkeeper, or whether Jurgen Klopp wants to admit it or not. Which, I'm pretty sure, after the West Ham game, he will admit it, because we were terrible against West Ham. Yes, their first goal was complete bullshit, but they would have won anyway. Liverpool had very few chances. Our best chances came from Chan and Lucas. Chan and Lucas! Yes, Chan has scored a goal for Liverpool since Jurgen Klopp came. He actually scored Jurgen Klopp's very first goal as Liverpool manager. Ironically. But Lucas, when was the last time Lucas scored a goal for Liverpool? I'm not trying to pick on Lucas. He's not a goal scorer. He's a center defensive mid. He's not paid to score goals. It's Christian Benteke's job to score goals, and he doesn't fucking do it. So he gets paid to do fuck all. That's what he does. He gets paid to do fuck all. He gets paid to stand around and hope the ball gets to him. And when he does get the ball, sometimes he can be good. Like, because the goals he scores, they're normally good. But when he's one-on-one, he loses all his nerve and fucking baits it at our Kasper Schmeichel or fucking Gaston Petelman or whoever the fuck was in goal for Sunderland, I don't even fucking remember. It's a fucking disgrace that our best, our best striker is injured. And our second best striker is injured. And our third best striker is injured. We're playing our fourth best striker from four. We have four strikers, and we're playing number four because that's all we have. Ings is injured until the end of the season. Daniel Sturridge is always fucking injured. I don't know how long the injury to Riggy is, but it's too long. He needs to play as soon as he's back. Put him in the first team, Jurgen, please. The kid scored a hat-trick against Southampton. And give him the chance again. He has clearly gotten the form now. Yeah, he didn't have the form at the start when you were playing him, but now he has it. So let him have the chance to shine, because you can't wait for Daniel Sturridge to come back. Heck. And at least until you sign a new striker, because you need to sign a new striker, or you can have someone who you can maybe rely on. Give Divock Origi the chance. Kick Christian Benteke out. just terminate his contract because the fucker doesn't deserve a contract with Liverpool Football Club. Oh. It's a fucking disgrace is what it is. It's a fucking disgrace. You know why I got rid of Christian Benteke as soon as I got into this career mode? Because I knew he wouldn't be good enough. But I tried to give him a chance, but I just knew. I couldn't do anything with Christian Benteke. Well, yes, Christian Benteke is good when he has a system that suits him. Like he had at Aston Villa. He is good with a team like Aston Villa. He would probably be good for a team like West Ham. Because West Ham have Andy Carroll. And are used to putting balls into the box to get to Andy's noggin when he's not injured. Or like they did today. Hey, I'm recording this the day of West Ham. I just went over Liverpool. In case it wasn't clear. So, Jurgen, you have plenty of time. Please. Because we're not going to get top four with what we have. You need to spend the money and you need to get the best you can get. Okay. Use your managerial experience. Use your keen eye for talent. You spotted the likes of Marco Reus and Robert Lewandowski when there were nobodies. And you turned them into the two of the world's greatest players. Simple. Oh, just do it for Liverpool. Just do that for Liverpool. Easy. Peasy. Job done. Thank you very much. You get a good defense, you get a good goalkeeper, you get a striker who'll get you 20 plus goals and suits our style. So that's anyone who doesn't fit the same description as Christian fucking Benteke. And not a big hulking striker who needs the ball fed to him and like a little baby waiting for his fucking ball. I don't know if it's clear, but I'm a bit pissed off. Just a bit. The fucking disgrace. The fact... It almost makes me want to ring up the English FA and just say... For future reference, can we just cancel all our games against West Ham and Crystal Palace and just give them the points? Just give them the points. Because... It'll save them a lot of fucking trouble beating us. Because we always seem to lose against West Ham and Crystal Palace now. What the fuck is going on? It's not good enough. It's a fucking disgrace. It needs to be sorted out. It needs to be nipped in the bud before it gets worse. And there's probably people sitting there thinking, how could it get worse? Oh, trust me, it could get worse. We could slip further down the table. Oh, and if we keep losing matches, then guess what? We're gonna keep slipping down the fucking table. And without Champions League football, Jurgen Klopp will have to damn near kiss ass to get a good player. So he needs to get them now. Get them in. Get them working towards the goal of getting top four. And do it while you can get top four. Because right now, we're not going to get top four. If we played like we played today, every single week, we'd be bottom of the fucking table. We were a fucking disgrace. Peace. Simple as that. We were a disgrace. Don't think this is over, because I'll be talking about the match more in depth when we do the Prem review. So don't think those players have gotten off easy. They have not gotten off easy. They will definitely hear from me again. Very soon. Fucking disgrace. Fucking pointless. Sick of this bullshit. Neymar, 1-0. I don't even know what to say now. I'm just gonna casually comment on this match. Klein brings the ball to Bale. We'll get the cross in. If someone wants to be there, that'd be fantastic. Just do your job, do what you're fucking paid for. Fucking idiots. Brian. Bale. Go on, Correa. Go on. Yes. Whip it in. Ugh. Continue. Shot's not offering itself up. Now a little back on defensive duties. First time for everything, I guess. Hey, Mark. Now here's Pepe, human red card. Henderson to Royce. Come on, get the win. Here's Ricardo Rodriguez. Not low.
James Rodriguez. Give me that. Oh, for fuck's sake! My players just keep fucking giving the ball away. Which is total fucking bullshit. Benzema, yes, good block there by doesn't even fucking matter. Continue. Sends a nice ball through to his Brazilian brother from another mother, Neymar. Henderson. Bale. Bale against his former club. Ooh. Bale has a goal against Spurs this season. Could just be the... Oh, off the post! Off the post! How did that not go in? Neymar! Deflected out for a corner. Brain. Fuck's sake. Ronaldo, James Rodriguez. Come here, you little tricky bastard. Cruz, Lucas. Yes, good tackle there by Nathaniel Klein. Although, Modric didn't do the best job at protecting the ball. If I'm being honest. But I don't care. Coutinho! Correa. And, being pulled back for something. Must have been offside. Skipped over the replay. There's a halftime. 1-0 at halftime. 5-0 on aggregate. Simple as that, really. Correa. Goal in the first 2 minutes of the second half, like in the first half. Oh, post again. For fuck's sake. Correa! Are you kidding me? Of course, why wouldn't I? Why wouldn't I? He had her just off target. Continue 2-0. Easy as you like it. It's 2-0, 6-0 on aggregate. Ronaldo is pissed. Real Madrid are pissed. As everyone is pissed. Well, everyone in white, that is. Korea. God, how did the keeper get there before you, Neymar? You have the pace. He's sick. Dude, use it. So, look at what my next Premier League fixture is. I'm gonna play the games between this and the next cup game off camera. Since I've already won the league, there's no point in showing you for a pointless match. See if I can help it. If there's any games between like the two legs of the next round of the Champions League, which I'm definitely going to be in.
Real Madrid are good, but they're not going to score 7 goals against a defense that has only conceded 3 in the league all season. To this point. Daniel Klein. Headed out by Danilo. Who's going to be in our corner. So yeah. That's a game against Newcastle in the video that went live today, or I'm recording this today. It's Saturday. That will be the last game of this season that you see. I've already won the league, so not that it fucking matters. Because I'm still the best that there is. Is in terms of management. Coutinho 3-0, 4 on the night, 7-0 on aggregate. Like I said, Real Madrid are good, but they're not going to score 8. Not against me, anyway. I'm not, whoever the fuck they scored 8 against here for week. It's some small team, anyway. But yeah, that, I'm not. My team is way too good to concede 8 in one game. I'd be surprised if I've conceded 8 goals at the end of the season overall. Not too keen on conceding goals though. Rice. Put them under some pressure. Come on. Fuck up, fuck up, fuck up, fuck up. They're not doing their job. They're not fucking up. Good tackle there by Rain. I must have the referee. I must have a corrupt referee. Hey, that was never a foul. Oh, thank you very much, you stupid, dopey man, but it didn't matter. And there's the full time whistle. Thank you very much. 3-0 on the night, 7-0 on the night. Yeah, hey, Barcelona won as well. Oh, what a fucking surprise. Let's see, Arsenal won, Man United won, Bayern and Ajax drew, I guess whoever went through will go through on away goals, Chelsea went through, and Neko went through, so all the big names went through, well, maybe minus Bayern, and definitely minus Real Madrid. Just saying, because I feel. Messi score a fucking hat trick. What a surprise. Let's see. Who did I get? Bayern did go through. Oh. And there is a game between the two. Who legs. Could there just not be? I have to sim that QPR game now. Oh. I don't want to do that. In any event. That's it for another video. Make sure to like if you enjoyed me ranting. I'm sorry if I went a bit overboard, but you know, you have to go overboard when you're passionate about something. And while I'm passionate about Liverpool, it's my life. It's what I live for, and it's what I'll live for till the day I die. So, smash the like button if you enjoyed listening to me rant on about how terrible Liverpool were against West Ham And the next time Liverpool are terrible. Well, I don't need you to smash the like button. Because next time they're terrible, I will give them the right heat rant that they deserve. And yeah. That'll just keep happening to happen until they sort the shit out. Subscribe if you want to see more of my videos. I don't rant about Liverpool in all of them. If this is your first video, don't worry. I won't rant too much. I'll get angry, but I won't rant too much. So there's that. So yeah, subscribe if you do want to see more rantless videos. And I will see you all next.